What's up, everyone? All right, so here we are finishing the day up $8,700. Green is good. Another really strong day of momentum. So I am happy about that. I just wanted to continue. Right now I'm up about $22,000 on the month, which is great, but it's still only about a third of the way of my $50,000, $60,000 target. So, you know, I need to keep the pedal to the metal. I'm hoping that we continue to see really good momentum this month because, you know, June was very slow and then picked up at the end. So right now we're coming kind of the fourth week of pretty hot momentum. And, you know, that could be around the time where the tide starts to shift. So I got to be on my toes and I got to be quick to adjust my share size if things do start to slow down, because I don't want to dig myself a hole that I have to spend the rest of the month getting myself out of. So right now it's still the time to be really, you know, aggressive, but a little cautious. All right, so we'll break down the trades from today in today's midday market recap. What's up, everyone? All right, so time for our midday market recap. We're gonna break down the trades from today. Finishing the morning up $8,795.47. You can see the P&L right there, upper left-hand corner. What a day. I mean, this is, you know, living the dream. It's just, it's crazy. You know, this life as a trader. I remember years ago, I would be happy if I'd made $800 in a day. And, you know, once I really got it, the only difference between making $80 a day or making $800 a day or making $8,000 a day or even making $80,000 a day ultimately is your share size. And the number of shares that you're willing to take is going to be relative to your risk tolerance and relative to your account size. So I've never met a trader, a profitable trader, who didn't slowly increase shares, because you just realize, gosh, if in the last week or in the last month I made, let's say, last month I made $37,000. So if I made $37,000 in the last month trading with 5,000 shares, what would have happened if I traded with 10,000 shares? Would I have made, you know, $72,000 or whatever? And you start realizing that the answer is yes, as long as you increase shares, you continue to trade the same way. And that's the only thing that some people run into issues with, is they trade with big size and then emotions start to change the way they trade. So you got to increase your share size slowly as you build it up. Now, I want to remind you guys, this coming Thursday, 1 p.m. Eastern, July 12th, we're hosting an encore workshop, and it is going to be awesome. I'm going to be teaching you guys my three secrets for trading success, how I made $8,700 today, how I've made, well, at this point, let's see, from a $583 account, I have made $672,000 of profit in the last, well, 18 months. That's crazy. Think about where you could be 18 months from now if you've got $600 in your pocket. Because I started with less than $600 in that account, and now I've got $672,000 of profit. And it's thanks to trading this one strategy that I'm going to be teaching in our workshop this coming Thursday. All right, so I want you guys to register. Click right now in the description. You can register. It's totally free, but seats are limited. We're going to limit seats because the last time we hosted this workshop in June, we had so many people attend that we ended up blowing out the servers, and it was, you know, it just created a major issue. So a lot of people missed it, and that's why we're hosting this encore here on Thursday. All right, so that's coming up on Thursday, but why don't we go ahead and break down the stocks from this morning. All right, so let's see, I'm gonna put up my screen share. All right, there we go. Okay, so as you can see, $8,795.47. What a morning. Now, this is actually, I was actually up $9,900. I'm down $1,100 versus my high watermark of the day, just because, you know, I kept pushing, I kept going for the next trade, and I ended up finally taking a loss. But today was a great day, and it's 11:15, so I've been trading for, well, I only traded for about an hour and a half. So $8,700 in an hour and a half, not bad. Now I'm averaging right now actually $2,716 per day for every day this year, every trading day this year. So that doesn't include weekends, but every trading day this year, I've been averaging $2,700 per day. So today I'm above the average, which is awesome. Yesterday I was a little below the average with $2,300. So I always like to be above the average if I can, because that helps bring my average up. So I'm gonna write this in my calendar. All right, so July 10th here, $8,795.47. It's the 124th day of the year. And that means, oops, right now I'm crossing $336,000 of profit on the year. Not bad. $327,000 to go. I'm just over the halfway mark of my profit target for this year. So I still have $327,000 to go to hit my profit target for 2018, which is a pretty aggressive target, I'm not gonna lie, but I think it can be done. I need to average about $3,000 per day for the rest of the year to hit the goal, which means I am a little bit behind right now, averaging only $2,700 a day. So whether I hit that $670,000 mark or not, I'm not sure, but today is another another good step in the direction. So here's the stocks I trade today. 2, 4, 6, 7 stocks, green on 5 out of 7. One big winner and the rest kind of small stuff, right? So how did this morning start? Well, as we'll talk about in the workshop later this week, this morning started just like any other morning. It starts by looking at this scanner right here, my secret weapon. This is my holy grail for finding stocks to trade. So this morning, I ran the scan, and this is showing me all of the stocks that are looking, that they're gonna open more than 5% versus yesterday's close. All right, so opening more than 5% is a sign of strength. I look at the ones that are really the top 10 of this list. So from here up. Now, seed, S-E-E-D, this was actually gapping up 897%. However, when you look at the chart, what you'll realize is that this was a reverse split. So the stock did a reverse split and it was not actually opening higher. So this is where yesterday, I don't know, it's a 10 to 1 reverse split. So yesterday, you would have been holding 10,000 shares at 70 cents. And now today it opens at $7, but you're holding only 1,000 shares. So it's just a reverse split. The amount of shares outstanding changes, but the amount of shares you're holding changes, but your actual value of the position doesn't change. So this is actually sort of an anomaly. It shouldn't really be considered a gap. All right, so the first real gapper on the list was BLIN. BLIN. So we pull this one up and you'll see on my P&L that I did trade it. I made $395 on this stock. All right, so pre-market, it had already moved up 129%, which is crazy. From $1.50, this nice pre-market flag, it breaks to the upside. Another flag here during the end of pre-market. And once the bell rang, I was watching this to jump in. I said, guys, I'm gonna be watching this for a break of $3. Okay, so here's $3. Here's the open price. We open at 290 and we surge up and we tap a high of 309. So on this one, I jumped in at 295 and 296 right here, anticipating the break of the whole dollar. We pop up and we hit 309, and then we dropped back down all the way to 265, and I sold, I think as it was coming back down, and I sold at 98. So I actually only made about $150 on that very first trade at BLIN. It wasn't a very big winner, but I got back in it as it started to surge back up. You can see it squeezed up here to a high of 324, pulled back, and then popped up to 335. And so I ended up getting back in it. Let me just scroll down here. I got back in at 315 right here and sold at 322. And then I want to say I added at 335. Yeah, I did. And I stopped out at 333. So that didn't end up being the biggest winner, only about $400 of profit. But I found this stock right off the watch list this morning. So I knew that it was going to be in play. I knew it had potential. It was just a matter of finding the exact entry. Now, the next stock down, OCX, no trades on that. It's 28 million share float, a little on the high side. It also trades in 5-cent increments, and it's not a former runner. Next one down, RSL. Now, this one I also traded, RSLS. I also traded this one out of the gates. I bought it at about the same time as I bought BLIN, buying at the same price also, $2.95, again, anticipating the break over the half dollar. This one, unfortunately, very weak today. However, it did give a little opportunity here as it popped up first to 305, which gave me a, I guess from $3 to 3 and 3. Yeah, so that was a small winner, only about 350 bucks. And then I got back in it as it surged. It popped up, pulled back, and as it surged back up here, I got back in and rode that momentum up to a high of 320, but it didn't hold that level and then it started to sell off. But in total, I made about $422. So on these two trades right off the scanners, it's about an $800 day, right? $800, not bad. I mean, that $800 a day keeps the job away. Absolutely. That is a great year if you're making $800 a day. And doing that, let's see. So by 9:31, I was already up $800. 9:32. So 9:31. So yeah, so a minute into the day, I'm already up 800 bucks trading these two stocks right off the scanners. All right, so now we also on the scanners had DCAR right here, which I was watching because this looked a lot like STAF yesterday. Remember yesterday, STAF had this pre-market flag that looked kind of like this. It had popped up, it pulled back. I'll just pull up another chart here to show you. We were looking at STAF for a couple different reasons today. Let's see, so let's go back to yesterday morning. All right, so this was the pre-market chart on STAF yesterday. Pretty similar, right? They both look kind of the same. And when you have one stock that's really strong yesterday like STAF was, this ended up hitting a high of $6, then you look, when you see another stock with a very similar setup, you're a little more likely to jump on it. All right, so I see DCAR looks similar, and on this one I jumped in as it started to squeeze up here. You can see it popped up to a high of $1.83. It hit the scanners and everything, but then it didn't hold those levels. It popped up DCAR 160, 177, maybe that was it. And it just didn't hold that level. So I got in 7,500 shares, captured some profit. Total profit on this was about $600. So now I'm up $1,400 on the day. Not bad, getting a little bit more in the green. So continuing to make progress. Next trade, let's see, so that was DCAR there, and then I had a trade on back in RSLS, that was a small win. And then I had SAEX. This one hits the scanners, and initially I wasn't totally, where was it? Right here, it hits the scanners at 220. Initially I wasn't sure, but it hits a high of 244, and then it pulls back, and so I'm like, all right, where was this? So it hits a high of 244, and I'm like, all right, well, at this point, this thing is up 56% today. I mean, it's actually up a lot. So I'm going to watch for a one-minute micro pullback, which was right here. So as it curls back up, it pulls back here, and as it curls back up, I buy right in here, and then it hits a high of 47, and it drops. And so on this one, I ended up losing $266, which is my worst trade of the day. But considering I had, let's see, 7,500 shares, it's really not that bad. I was able to start getting out quickly once I realized there was some resistance up here. And I can see resistance when you see a lot of buying, but the price isn't breaking. So I was like, all right, I'm just going to start getting out of this and, unwinding this position, which I did. And then, that was it. So lost 266 bucks. Whatever, not that big of a deal. All right, next trade on the list here, GBR. So this one, I'm iffy on GBR. It had this crazy move last week. I made like $10,000 on it. I made some good money on it, but it had this horrible red day. Well, today, from a technical perspective, was the first day it was making a new high. After four red days in a row, today it started to go green. And sometimes you see buyers jump in as it starts to turn around. So this, so right here, as it started to curl up over 320, what was it, $4.420, that's where I was like, okay, I'm gonna take a stab. So I got in at 412, and I was a little more aggressive on this because at this point, so now I'm taking 10,000 shares. At this point, I'm already up over 1,000 on the day, so I'm feeling a little more confident. And I'm thinking, all right, you know, this one's taking off. I mean, it clearly just squeezed from a $3.40 to $4. So I'm gonna step it up a little bit here and see if this goes into a halt. Maybe we get a short squeeze. Anyone who's been short for 3 or 4 days is gonna cover, and the thing will go to $5. It's not impossible for this type of setup to get that type of breakout. It's a technical setup. Even without news, this is a technical setup. It's the first daily candle to make a new high. So I jump in, it hits a high of 440. But it doesn't end up getting halted, and then it drops down. And although this is, you could say, is a 1 minute pullback, it had pulled back too much for me because it came all the way down to 395. So then I was thinking, okay, well, in this area here, maybe it'll consolidate under 420, and maybe I could get in here, but then it broke the low of this level. And so now it's just stair-stepping down, 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 down. So made some money on that, but nothing super exciting. All right, next one is CLWT. This one is the most disappointing one of the day. And I'll say, before I show that one, I was a little disappointed when I saw CHCI hit the scanners, pop up, and immediately get slammed back down. You know, that kind of made me a little nervous. SAEX did the same thing. I knew RSLS wasn't holding up very well. So I started thinking I got to be a little careful today because we're seeing a number of stocks popping up and fading. So I need to see something really show some strength. And CLWT, I was probably too aggressive on it given what we had just seen. But it hits the scanners, and I knew that this is a former runner because this is a stock that in one day went from a low of $2.30 to a high of $8.45. 400% in one day. That's crazy. So knowing that this is a former runner with this history of making big moves, when it hit the scanners, I was willing to jump in pretty quickly. So let's see, where is it? It hits the scanners at 470 right here, and I jumped in at $5. Now, I got in, I only got a partial fill, and I tried to add, but my orders didn't get filled, and then it ended up being halted on a circuit breaker. So it's halted at 515. It resumes and taps a high of 570, and I sold at 550, made $850, and then I added back at 550 and 568, thinking that this was a 1 minute micro pullback right here, and that it was gonna go higher. But sort of like SAEX, that did not happen. It hit a high of 590, and I wanna say I sold some, no, I guess I sold at 70. I sold half of it break even basically. And then it drops all the way down here to 480, which is disappointing. Nobody likes to see that. And so I stopped out at 510 and gave back my $850 of profit from the first trade. So I went from being up about $1,000 on this one to up to down 100. And that was disappointing. So at that point, you know, I had gone to be up $3,000 on the day to up only about $1,800 or something like that, $1,900. Which again, $1,900 is still a great day, but of course $3,000 is better. So then MTSL hits the scanners. And this was the last one. So MTSL hits the scans right here at $1.67, $1.70, and it gets halted. Now, I don't get in before the halt. I see it pop up, hit the scanner, and get halted, and I'm like, okay, well, you know, let's just see if this stock shows some strength. So it was halted right here at $1.84. Some of you guys, I bet, did get in before it got halted because you were a little faster than me. Now, one of the things that's cool is that you guys all have access, Warrior Pro students, to these same exact scanners as I have. So we're seeing these stocks in real time at the same time. I don't have any advantage. I'm not seeing them before you. You're seeing them at the same time as me. And you may be on that trade more focused or more willing to jump, and you may get in it sooner and get in it faster. So on this one, some of you guys probably got in at $1.80, $1.84, whatever. I didn't get in there. It was halted, but as it resumes, I jumped in for the break of $2. So right here, I get in with 7,500 shares as it comes out of the halt, and it squeezes up to a high of 213. All right, so I make a little money. I sell some at 208, sell some at 206, whatever. I then add back at 206, because now I'm like, okay, it's actually holding up pretty well. And right here, it's doing a 1 minute micro pullback. So on this one, I added, and on this one, it worked. It pops up to 20, and then up to a high of 27. And so I'm like, all right, very nice, very nice. So I made some money there. And then you can see here, it starts to pull back, and this is doing another 1 minute pullback. And then suddenly it drops here down to a low of 189. And I'm thinking, oh boy, down to 189, that's not what I like to see. And I sold the rest of it at 203. This was a little scalp here, whatever, a couple scalps. Let me look for where. Okay, so this is where things started to get interesting. So on MTSL at this point, I'm only up like a couple $100. I'm up 2,000 something on the day, but not a big win on MTSL, just, you know, a little bit of profit. All right, so then you can see here it's going sideways, and it drops down to 189, and I'm like, all right, another one that's dead. You know, this one's just gonna probably fade from here or whatever. It's done. And then all of a sudden, it surges back up and goes through the highs. So I keep high of day on watch. And so as it started to curl up, I was like, okay, I don't understand why that just happened, but this thing is going and I'm jumping in. So I jump in here with 10,000 shares, 7,500 shares at 28 and 29. So I start with 7,500 shares. Once I'm up $750, I add another 2,500 shares. So now I've got 10,000. And then I added another 2,500 and another 2,500. So now I have 15,000 shares right here. And I'm like, this thing just clearly is taking off. It's showing incredible strength. And so it goes up to 61, and I add again at the half dollar, and again at 55, and again at 60. So now I have 20,000 shares. So basically all day I traded with a max of 10,000 shares, and then all of a sudden I see this opportunity, I step up to the plate and I take 20,000 shares. So now I've got 20,000 shares of this stock, I have 18,000 as of right here, and it gets halted on another circuit breaker. So on this one candle, just in 1 minute, it had 216,000 shares of volume. So it had a lot of volume for sure, and I jumped in with 20,000 shares or 18,000. It's then halted, and it resumes higher and squeezes up to a high of 85. So as it resumes, I add another 2,500 at 60, and then I sell half at 77. I sell another quarter at 77. So now I've sold 15,000 shares from basically 37 to 77, which is awesome. And then I sell a little bit more at 74, and then it dips down as it curls back up. I add back at 73 and 77. I then sell at 83, 82, and I add back at 80, and I add at 90, and then I stopped out at 86, and I stopped out of the rest down here at 84 and at 60. So I was up a total of $10,000 on the day, and then on this little drop right here, I gave back about $1,000. So, you know, today's a day where I'm finishing up $8,795, and I know I could have done a little bit better. Because I gave back a little profit there. I gave back a little profit on CLWT. So that's the really cool thing with trading, is that even when you have really good days, you know you can do better. And that's why I know that there will be a day at some point where I have an $80,000 day. Today was an $8,700 day. That was good. The best day I've ever had so far, $40,000 in one day. So today's not even my best day. Today's a good day, and I'm very grateful and very thankful that it's a good day, but this isn't a record breaker. This isn't a day where I'm going to do anything special tonight or celebrate. This is just a decent day of trading. That really is all it is. $8,700, it's a decent day. $40,000 is a great day. $50,000 would be a great day. If I have an $80,000 or a $100,000 day, that will be an amazing day. That will make me really excited. And, you know, that's my goal, eventually to have a $100,000 day. I just think that would be a really amazing thing, you know, to have happen. But right now, the best day is $40,000. And on that day, we had incredible momentum in the market. I mean, it was incredible. We were seeing multiple stocks do this. And so I was buying one, and then the next, and the next, and the next, and the next. And I traded like 12 stocks that day, and I made between $5,000 and $20,000 on each one of those stocks. I mean, it was just back to back to back to back, and you know, boom. That's where you know, that's where I really locked up some profit. So, anyways, you know, today's a good day, and considering it's July, it is pretty great, because the reality is summertime is often a little bit slower. Right? It's not uncommon that things are a little slower in the summer, and this is a good time for us to study and be in the classes and, you know, just focus on discipline. So having a couple of big wins during the summer is great. I made $8,000 last Monday. I made $7,700 last Thursday, and I'm up $8,700 today. So today right now is the best day of the month, which is great. And, you know, I'm feeling good about this momentum that we're seeing. The market is hot. So, you know, this is definitely the time for me to put the pedal to the metal and be aggressive and try to capitalize as much as I can, because inevitably we will have days, whether it's later this week or next month, where the market starts to slow down a little bit and where I'll have to make do with making only $1,000 a day, right? And just, you know, that's just the way it goes. June for me was really slow to start, and then in the last 2 weeks I made like $55,000. So, you know, I pulled it together for the month of June, but it was a really slow start and I lost some money in the first couple weeks. Here in July, I'm having a pretty strong start. Made $12,000 last week and I'm up $10,000 or $11,000 this week. So that's good. My goal pretty much is, you know, about $10,000 to $15,000 a week. I really need to be averaging $15,000 a week in order to hit my $670,000 goal for this year. But I'm not really putting a lot of pressure on myself to do that, because the reality is there are going to be weeks where I make $50,000 and then there'll be weeks where I make only $2,000 or $3,000. And so it really comes down to averages. I can't get bent out of shape if I have a week where I make only $2,000 or $3,000, because I know I'll make it up down the road, you know, and so that's kind of, you know, where I'm at right now. But anyways, that's about it for today. A pretty great day. I mean, just, you know, for the most part, good momentum. And it really came down to that one stock, which is MTSL. Yesterday it was STAF, STAF. This was the one yesterday that made my day. And yesterday I lost money, and then I spent the rest of the day digging myself out of the hole until I finished up $2,300. So fortunately today I didn't go into the red. I started green and just, you know, kept it going. All right. So anyways, we'll be back at it first thing tomorrow morning. Same routine, pre-market analysis, 9:15, you know, breaking down stocks on the watch list. Once the bell rings at 9:30, we'll start trading. And, you know, hopefully we'll continue to see this momentum carry through the rest of the week. I would love to just see this be a really great week of trading. And that would be a nice way to start the month of July. All right, so that's it for me, and we'll be back at it first thing tomorrow morning. So any of you guys watching on YouTube, on Facebook, feel free to leave comments below. I'll come back through and answer all of them later this afternoon. All right, I read all the comments. I love seeing them. So yeah, feel free to put down questions, put down comments, and I'll answer them later. All right, I'll see you guys in the morning. Bye, everybody. If you're still watching, you must have really enjoyed that video. So why not subscribe and get email alerts anytime I upload new content? Remember, when you subscribe, you become a member of the Warrior Trading family.